Hi everybody, this is Els, Elizabeth Craft Designs, for a new Facebook Live. And I think it's going to be fun again, because I was working this morning on, let me see, videos. I need to go to groups. There we go. And I was working on something this morning and I thought, oh, that's fun. It's always a last minute, you know, somehow it's always a last minute thing with me, because then I have the best ideas. I think I work best under stress. Let me see, there we go. The video live is ended. No, that's this one. Here we are. That's the old one. I don't want that one. Let me see if I update. Yeah, there I am. Okay. Hello, everybody. I need to put the comments on. I have a lot of ink there. Let me slide it up a little bit because I'm not going to work with that right away. That one. Alrighty. Hello, everybody. How are you all doing? Let me see who is there. I don't see that. Yeah, okay. Alice is watching. Toki is watching. Hello. Anita van der Wiel is watching. Hi, everybody. And Siglin de Roske. Hi. And Joep is watching. Hi, Joep. All worked out again, you know. I thought, oh, doesn't work again. But at the end, it always works out. But hi, Miranda. Hope you're feeling better. And Anita's watching. Hi, Anita. I took some things of cards from you, so you will see that in a second coming up. And Rieke is watching. Hi, everybody. And I know Anna put like in the text that it was going to be 12:30 and the announcement 12. So I don't hope people come in too late. So if you have friends that you think need to know, contact them now. So welcome everybody. So I wait for like one more minute and then we're about to start. I hope you're all doing okay. I hear in the Netherlands it's very, very, very hot. So hi Jackie from the UK. How is the weather in the UK? Also hot. And Diane. Hi Diane. Going to talk to you in a bit. And Odraatje, hi. So just waiting for like a minute more to have people come in. And especially, hi from Yosemite. Wow, that is gorgeous. Been there, of course. Yeah, that's gorgeous. And Diane Houtman is watching. And Denise, hi everybody. So over here, it's actually, you know, it's quite nice weather as well, but we have some rain in between. Hi, Joseph. How is the weather in San Francisco? Miranda, better but bored, out of my brains. I can imagine. Sitting still. Hi, Esther. Sitting still is not the crafty thing to do. Like, crafty people want to be busy, either on the craft table, on the desk, or everybody. So doing nothing is not my thing. So I hope you can craft very quickly again. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, $50 gift certificate for Monday was for Sil Lopez. So congratulations, Sil, with the $50 gift card. And then we also had the bonus $50 gift certificate for the favorite card from the slim cards that we did on Monday. And you responded like very, you know, you responded a lot. So that's good. And I appreciate that. Thank you so much. And the winner of that $50 gift certificate is Elliot Black. And she picked, if Anna said she picked the bird card, so the green bird card. So Elliot, what I'm going to do as well, I'm going to send you that card. So Elliot, $50 gift certificate, and I'm going to send you the card as well. And the other $50 gift certificate is for Sil Lopez. So congratulations, and I hope you spend it well. And of course, if you like, comment and share this one. This Facebook Live, you get another chance to win a $50 gift certificate. Hi, Sandy. Hi, Antoinette. So what are we going to do? Oh, I need to do one more announcement, or actually two. We have a special, because I'm going to work with the collection from Josette. And for today and tomorrow, if you order online, you get a 20% discount. And I need to ask Anna, because Anna is not here right now. Anna, did you install that for the Netherlands as well, for the European website? So 20% discount on the full collection from Josette today and tomorrow using code Josette20. So 20% discount on the full collection. And I'm going to use Moda scrap paper. And this one is more for Europe as for the US, because in the US we're almost sold out of the paper, but there's still some. So check it out. But all the Moda scrap paper in the Netherlands, and we have a lot over there. So go and check it out. This is your chance. The Moda scrap paper, the 6x6 from €5.95 for €2.50. And the 12x12 pads, all the Moda scrap from €10.95 for €5. So that is for the European website and for the US. But in the US, we're limited stock. But in the Netherlands, in our European warehouse, we have a lot of Moda scrap paper. So grab it now. 6x6 for €2.50. The 12x12 for $5. And the one I'm using today is mostly the smaller one, the 6x6. But I am using the SeaWorld. So this paper pack I'm using today. But they have a big selection there. Somebody said, I need to send my paycheck over to ECD. I'm sorry, Sandy. As long as I always say, as long as you have fun with the product, it's all as long as it gives you joy, you know, it's good. It's good. So we have that. Let me show you. So we have that paper in the 6x6 and 12x12. So I use mostly the 6x6 today, but of course you can cut everything out of the 12x12 as well. So beautiful paper, and so grab it now. So what I'm going to do, we are all very excited about the, hoor je dat, Aniek, papier net besteld. Oh, okay. Diane Houtman says, oh, she just ordered it. Yeah, grab your chance now. So European warehouse, lots of Moda scrap paper, €2.50, €5. So I'm going to work with the shell, and we love our mini books, like the camera. We love that one, the camera die. I made them. What did I do? I made another mini book. Oh, with the hearts last week. And that was fun to do. And I had this one in my mind earlier. But I didn't get to it. So now I thought I'm going to do this one. So what I'm using here. I'm using the Under the Sea collection. And then the shell. So that's this base. And I'm going to show you the die in a second. And then I made this card as well. Wishing you oceans of joy. You see? So that's that one. With a crab. So fantastic collection. And super fun to do. Okay, so what is the collection, the Under the Sea collection? This is the shell die. So that's the base that I'm using. And then these parts come with it. So that's a kind of a puddle, but there's a pop-up part as well. And I'll show you that in a second. I have that cut already. And then I have a little pearl with that as well. Then we have the edges. So we have this one. We have the mermaid. We have the turtle, we have the treasure chest here with all the accessories, seaweeds. We have the whale, we have the crab, we have the octopus, we have all the shells with the little crab here. And then we have the lighthouse, all the accessories, and that's the collection. But of course, what you also can use for the people that have that already, or we still have that available, is the collection with the flamingo and the tropical flowers. So that kind of goes with this theme as well. So fun to do. And I did an earlier video making this one. I don't know if that was a Technique Friday or I think this was a live as well or a Technique Friday. So I made that sliding card and that was fun to do as well. So lots and lots of fun things to do. Okay, so what I did, I cut all these parts already. So that's all the shell. And this time I'm going to show you how to die cut that, because I used one of the Planner Essential or the Sidekick collection as well. And somehow that turned out to be perfect, which I didn't know when I started, but it turned out to be perfect. So let me tell you what I did. So basically for this one, for the half pages, I used a 6x6. So let me get a page for that. Just a second. I have one here with the fish bones. Oh, and it's a little birdie. I have that already. I don't know if I cut this one already. Okay, so what you're going to do, I'm going to get my big shot. Get that in place. And I have short plates here. And I will show you as well, because I'm at the studio, so I only have short plates here. But for this one, it all works well. Because what I wanted, when I cut those pages, I wanted to have the embossed lines in all my pages. So if I do a double and then cut it, I don't have embossed lines on that side. So I don't want that. So what I did is, I took my paper, and I'm going to take a piece of removable tape. And I kind of put it on the side so you have a little bit piece left that you can use as well. And then you die cut this one. And the Sidekick collection will be back in stock, I hope before the end of the month. For people that lucked out on that one. I hope my table isn't, it should not be wobbling because the camera is loose from the table. So that is this one. So you die cut this one. Then, my paper is hanging in there on the tape. So then you have your solids. Then I'm going to take a scissor. Where's my Tim Holtz scissor? Oh, here it is. And I'm going to just cut it on the score line. So very easy. And then I found out, because I was going to use the strip from the Planner Essentials. So I have this strip. Sidekick, not Planner Essentials. Because the Planner Essentials line doesn't fit as perfect as this one. You can probably make it work by just making a mark. Because that one in the Planner Essentials, we have this strip as well. But this one turned out to be the perfect size to make the holes. And I'm going to show the correct way. And I'm also going to use it the wrong way. Because that's what I did as well. So I take the strip. And you slide it on here, exactly in the corner, against the cut line. Tape it. And now you're going to run it through. And as it ends up, those holes work perfectly because it is exactly in the center of that shell. So that was just a coincidence, I have to say, but a happy one. You see how perfect that is? So this one is exactly in the center and you have those two. So what I did first, when I cut my first shell, let me show you what I did wrong then. So you need to make sure you line it up here. Because the first one, I did the other way around and I'll show you what happened. So I lined it up here. Oh, I actually cut this one already, but I'm going to show you anyway. So this one has the holes already, but just imagine it doesn't have the holes. So I was doing this, run this through. Nikki van Ooyen, kijk of ik terug kan kijken. Nikki, you can always watch back. And all our videos are on YouTube as well. Look at that, what happens. When you put it in wrong, you cut off the bottom part. Because one part of this die has a cutting line. So make sure you line it up, you line your shell up against the cutting line here and not this way. Because otherwise, and you do it only, you know, you do it wrong once. Because then I thought, oh, that's stupid. But only do it once and then you know what you did wrong. So don't do that. Then there's another thing that I'm going to cut right away as well before I start working on the book itself. I was going to use, I want to make like a piece of, let me show you, because this is going to be the front of my card or of my book. And I wanted a piece of kind of wavy part there. So what I'm going to do first, and in that case, so now in this case, I don't want the embossed lines in there. So now I'm going to take a piece of cardstock. And this one has tape on the back. So it has a double-sided adhesive on the back. Just trim a part off. So now I'm going to line it up on this one. Because I don't want the embossed lines on there. So again, take a little piece of tape. So again, today and tomorrow, we have a 20% off Yozette's collection using Yozette 20 with checkout, plus all the Moda scrap paper, especially for the people in Europe. All the Moda scrap paper is 250 for the 6x6 and 5 euros for the 12x12. So that's a steal because normally that's 10.95. Okay, so now I have this part without embossed lines. And then I'm going to take my waves here. So the edges. I want to do this one. Kind of a more elegant one because I'm going to use the mermaid with that. So there's all kind of ways that you can kind of work with the different dies, of course. So now this one, because this is going to be the top, the front of the book, you see. So I want to line this up, but I want to have some waves here. So I'm going to take the wave die, going to line it up. Again, take a piece of tape, otherwise it will maybe slide. You don't want that. Monique said, up too late. Monique, you can always watch back and you will see the finished product for sure, the finished project for sure. So going to line this up. Put this here, little tape here. And then we're going to run that through as well. And then I can put my die cutting machine away and start playing. For now, maybe I'll pick it up again. Oh, and for the people, let me show you that as well, because I get a lot of questions about that, and I made a video once, but we still get questions about people that they say, oh, I have the small die cutting machine. Let me show you that as well. If you have the short plates, because this is a long die, so let me trim out kind of what I need. So I'm going to line this up again, take a piece of tape, especially now I need some tape. So, and this one needs to be kind of straight, so I line it up. I kind of see a line here that I can line it up. So tape this, so make sure it's straight. So if you have your short plates, what you do, because you see this is too long for those short plates. So if you have a cuddle book or just short plates, this will work perfectly. So what you do, you go in. That's enough. I go out again. So now I have this side cut already, you see? So now you line up this out of the plates and you just cut it from this side. So if you have only short plates or a cuddle book or a machine that's too short, this one will do it. And I don't go on, because sometimes you get a line there, so I prefer to go back now. So you don't get a line in your paper, although with this solid metal die you won't have that. But you see, now you have a perfect cut shell here. So that's just to show you how that works, because we get sometimes it comes back all the time. And there's actually a YouTube about it, but you see, so now I have my card here. So that's just a tip if you have smaller plates. Okay, let me get this out of the way. Make sure it doesn't drop, because last on Monday something dropped and it was like a lot of noise. Okay. Added to my wish list. Yeah, Joseph. And Sue is watching. Hi, Sue. Sue will be on live next week on the 1st of July. And on Friday we have Suzanne Nee. So, hi, Charlene is watching as well. So we have a lot of things happening at the moment, and it's all exciting. Oh, let me get this straight. Alrighty, so let's get my parts here. So what I did, I die cut a lot of pages already. And I die cut one out of watercolor paper again, because I love that. So look at that, how cute is that going to be as a book? So I can just add those pieces. You see, so that's going to be my little book for the holiday. How cool is this? Because we have the photo camera, which is great. But what if you go on a beach holiday? How fun is this? So we have that as well. So, oh, this one needs to go the other way around. I see. Alrighty, so this was going to be my first page. And I wanted to use the waves on there. So that's this one. First, I'm going to edge those waves a little bit using, well, I don't want to use this one because that's too bright. I'm going to use just the weathered wood, I think. It will give it a little color. So that's going to be the front of the book. Just a little bit, a little touch, not everywhere. Just on the... And paper I used here, so normally, of course, we always use our soft finish cardstock. I did not do that this time. And why? Because the paper, the Moda scrap paper, is one-sided, printed one side, and it's not totally white on the inside. So if you use like a bright white paper then with that here, like this, you see, it doesn't look nice unless you color it all, of course, which we will come to in a second. So that is my birdies. And then this one has the double-sided adhesive. And now I'm going to line it up like this. And of course, I need to make sure that I line it up, so I slide it a little bit down. I hope I'm still in the camera. Here we go. And this way, here we go. You see, so now I have my waves there. And then I had I'm going to edge this a little bit as well. I don't know, well, maybe in the same, just a little touch. I'm going to do that here as well. Because I like it not to be, but only a tiny bit here. And then here as well. Here we go. So that's that one. And then I have, here I took this from, it was on one of the, how do you call that? Fishtails, Anita, you know it. It was on the fishtails. So I took this one off because how cute was that on the front of the book. So this one is created by Anita Eisendoorn, and then this is all white soft finish cardstock. And Anita colored it all. So of course, by coloring it all, you don't see the white anymore. So always for like the coloring, but you see, I took it off, you see. I sometimes do that. And Anita knows that I do that. And this was actually on a board for Expo. And since we don't have any shows, you know, it's a waste to leave them there on the board. Look at that. Her coloring is just exquisite, of course. How cool is this? What if Annika sees this, my granddaughter? She wants to make this. How cool is that? So that is the mermaid sitting on the in the waves. And then, of course, I need my reinforcements on that as well. And I did cut some reinforcements. And because this is like a shorter part here now, I cannot use all the reinforcements. But I want it because some will be too long. But I want to have like, so basically what I did all the little rings. And this is from the same collection of paper. You see, kind of not too kind of hard in color, so it kind of matches nice together. There we go. So I saw a picture from Charlene earlier, like sitting in a, well, she sent it to us, like not on Facebook, but sitting in a tub because it's apparently outside because it's so warm apparently in the Netherlands. So you need a pool now, I hear. Yeah, Charlene, are you watching from your pool? Hi, Rick. Rick is watching as well. So Rick is an old colleague of mine in the Netherlands. Hi, Rick. So that's that. You see, so that's going to be the front. And then I have some pieces that I'm going to use to decorate the pages as well. And of course, I have some more fun things to put on pages. And I have to say, some work of Josette, some work of Anita, because I did not have the time to make the new all the new elements because I only came up with this idea. No, that's not true. I had the idea earlier, but it's always, you know, planning for me. And you know, Joep knows, Anna knows. Then I think, oh, I'm going to do this. And then I have another idea that I think, oh, that's more fun. And then I'm going to do that. So that's how it goes. So 30 degrees Celsius. Wow, that is warm. And Diana says, is there a YouTube? How long? Oh, yeah, there is. Oh, I don't know, Diane. I will show you. You know, basically it's easy. But I don't know if Esther is there, because Esther is going to do next week, a Tuesday. And she might be able to show that as well. Hi, Suzanne. I just told people that you will be on here on Friday. Hi, Marianne from the Netherlands as well. And then I see Joep. And then Joep says, why? And then I come home and then Joep says, did you see the discussion on the live? And then I totally missed it because you cannot see all the comments. So you can joke about me whatever you want. I don't see it. So that's that one. Look at that. Isn't that going to be cute? So what I thought I would do, because on this one, I want to use circles. Because the circles work perfectly in the in the shape of the shells. So that is cool. So I have different circles already. And I did print a few pictures already that I thought I'm going to use. And this one, I'm not going to put the picture here, but I will put some paper here for sure. Oh, and this one, I noticed, you see, I cut the anchors like downwards. Then you can use this way, you see, because then you have it like up as well. So you can use it different ways, the paper. Let's leave this like this. Oh, and this one has this. So I might just do that circle here. And I'm not decorating the whole book, of course, because I'm just starting. And that's where all the projects, like when I did the heart book, that is actually on my table at home because I loved that heart book that we did. And here you can see as well. So I don't know, let me show it in the camera. So this is the 12 by 12 paper. This is the 6 by 6. So the 6 by 6 has the same pattern, but then smaller, which is fun to combine, of course. So you see, so you can just build that book and then add your pictures, of course. And I love that idea that you can just keep working on it. And that's what I say all the time, and it's honestly true. I love working in the planners, in the sidekicks, like making the mini books. It's so much fun because I don't need to finish it today. I can work on this later. And if we get the opportunity, and I hope we will as family, we can actually travel, but that we can see the grandkids in not too long. We need to quarantine again, but we can visit. But yeah, you know, they're growing fast. They're growing fast. See, so I do some reinforcements here. So my idea was with this one, I can either use the circles, or I also have the small squares. Let me find these, because this will work nicely as well, because I want to kind of keep it, oh, I like the gold as well. I kind of want to keep it a little bit more, like more simple with the reinforcements. So I'm going to put reinforcements everywhere, but I'm not going to use the large one in this case, because some of them will be a little bit too large, I think, for this one. But you see, the little squares work perfectly as well. Diane Princess, this is a cute... I know, Diane, you live at the water. So Diane Prince lives at a lake in Canada, if I'm correct. And so when the grandchildren are coming and all your water pictures can be used in a book like this. How cool is that? Do that with the grandchildren. You see, so I like this idea instead of using the larger reinforcements in this case. So let me see... Oh, this one is actually a full card. I'm going to show you that in a second as well. That is the watercolor. Here I have... Oh, let me put a picture here. And I might add some ink here later. And it's all, you know, I can do whatever we want. And I printed two pictures. This is actually both from the time that we had a wedding. And I used because, you know, we had such great pictures. So this is on the water in the Netherlands, in Maassluis. So Tom and Annika... And this is actually at the beach, but of course Annika didn't want to take off her wedding dress, the bridesmaid dress, for days. So this is at the beach, her jumping with the same wedding dress. And then here is Tom sitting on the trampoline waiting for his turn for Opa to hold him and to let him jump. So what I used here, so the tape on the back of this one, and let me show you because we have different sets of circles, and you will find those in the collection from Josette as well. So those are all 20% off as well. So I use the stitched one. So the stitched one, the scalloped one, that's what this one is. And it has scallops and then little dots in there. So a kind of a dots scallop. And then the regular ones. So those are the ones I've used for the kind of for all the circles, because I think that's a nice shape to use here. So I'm going to put this one here. And you can also just cut a frame because I have those as well. So this one I did the full circle. And then I have a picture here from Tom and Annika. I'm going to put some tape on the back. So you can see this will be a fun, fun project as well. So again, using the Sidekick collection, like that little strip there, it just gives you more and more possibilities. And that's what I love. I say it all the time. That's what I love about our collections. Like, it all works so well together. The art journal, Sue, Suzanne, Josette. It all works fantastic. And then, of course, the art journal is from Ilse and Charlene. And the sidekick and the planners are from Esther. So now I have everything with straight. So now my water needs to line up with this straight line. So I hope I can see that correctly. I actually have, I have something with that. Sometimes people, you know, when you take a picture of the sea, I let my iPhone correct it right away, because sometimes you see the sea going like this. And I think, no, that's not the sea. That's, you know, that's not the sea. It's a straight line. The horizon is a straight line, I think. So, but a lot of times I see, and then I think, oh, no, not straight. Okay, so let me get some. I have some of this paper here from the red one with the seaweed. put some reinforcements on there. And of course, I'm going to edge that. So again, it doesn't need to be. I'm going to write a little bit one on the little bit in this one as well, but it doesn't need to be like too much. It can just be a fun photo album for the kids. Let me see this one. And then I want to edge this page a little bit as well. So you can see you can kind of build up your, and I'm going to stick with that this color in this case. So this is the weathered wood I'm using. So I'm going to edge the page a bit. And again, not all the way, but just, I don't want it to be too strong. And I was texting with Diana this morning from Canada, and then said, can I call you right now? And I said, no, you can't, because I need to prep first because of my last minute idea again. And that's, or prep. Just do the same here. And you can see, so this will have something as well, but I will work on that later. So that's just a page. So let me see what else I have on paper, because I have another picture and I have all these circles that I can put in there as well. So just as a start, because, so this one, so this is the stitched one. And then of course I have a fitted circle that fits in there. So then I can add the paper later. You see this one? Can go on here, you see that is nice, so I can do that. But I'm also going to add some of the images. Let me add this circle on there. So it's just going to be a fun book with images, so all from the Under the Sea collection, which is now, and I'm probably going to put a flamingo in there as well, because I thought that would be cool, like the beach, so beach theme. And for the collection from Yozette, 20% if you use the code Yozette20. You see, so that kind of that paper kind of matched better with the. Let me see. No, not that one. I'm going to use a different one here. That one will be nice there. So, oh, that one has tape already as well. So you can just build the book. You know, you just start. And then you just add things. And of course, I put that circle here. But then I can put an ocean edge there. I can put anything there. I might do that in a second. And I have, let me see, because I have that one. I have a lighthouse. The lighthouse will be nice here, I think. So I'm going to put a lighthouse in this one again. It is from Anita. Anita made this one. So the lighthouse will be nice on there. And then I can put some shells later. You know, you can basically put anything there. So it's going to be fun. And then in this case, I'm going to put my picture there. So you can put your picture on either page, of course. Can be the top one or it can be the bottom one. Let's see here. So that's the lighthouse, you see. And then going to have a picture here. Oh, actually, this one fits here. Shall we put that one there? That's cool. But no, I actually have pictures that I'm visiting a lighthouse. That one is going there. That one is going there. So leave that one. And this one, let me see, I also have this circle, for instance. So this one I did, and then I cut out. So that was just came together with the one. You see, that was the outside of this one. So I just cut it twice. And because it has tape on the back, it's very easy to kind of glue down there as well. Or like it better here, maybe. Yeah, do that. So you see, so that's kind of how you start building your book. And I love that. And again, I have the hard, I'm working on my hard book. And now I have the shells here. And I know for sure the grandkids will love this. And I actually do as well. Because I love working on those mini books. Yeah, so you, here you are. And then I'm ready to put another, you know, another picture in there. Or I can actually add another circle if I want to. But that one doesn't match. But this one is too big. That's a, oh yeah, this is a stitched one. If you actually use the stitched one, then you still see the scalloped from the scallop one as well. And this is a smaller scallop one that can actually go in there as well. But I don't like that as much. So it's not going to happen for now. So let me do this first. And now I want to show you, because there is one in here, because you can do that as well. Let me see where it is. This one is actually the full card, because you can put that in your mini book as well, of course. So what I'm going to show you, I'm going to show you the pop-up part. So let me get the die. So this is the die that I use for that. So it comes with the shell. So it's included in the shell. So this is kind of the puddle. So you can use it as a puddle on the beach. You can all do all that. But it also has a pop-up part in there. And let me show you how you do that. Oh, I'm so way behind on... Hi, Patricia, Sharon, Tracy. It's been a beautiful day. Still too warm. Yeah, you know, I'm not... Joep says last minute planning with lots of changes. Yeah, I actually started something else, but you know. Let's go. Hi, Esther. Here you are. Esther, did you see the question? There was a lady asking, sorry, I forgot your name, but asking how you make the longer page using this strip. So from the Sidekick or the Planner Essentials. So Esther, if you can show this, demo this on Tuesday, that would be great. Thank you. Taken care of. I hope she still is watching. But so the puddle here. So what you do, you just die cut that piece, like, what's the shape? Oh, here you go, yeah. So this way. So you just run it through. And you can also make, and then you make a score line. So I made my score line here in the middle. You can also make a score line here, so then it will be folding a different way. But I have it in, like, in the middle here. So make a score line. Then you take your pop-up piece, you put it on here. And I know I have videos using this card as well. So YouTube. So if you go to Elizabeth Kreisler's YouTube channel and then Technique Friday with Els, you will find this as well. So you put it on here. The only thing that's important is that your pop-up piece, like the nibs here on the outside, are lined up with the embossed line. And then you run it through. And then you basically just fold it like this, you see. And then you have a pop-up part. And of course, I can use that in... Oh, no. Oh, Els, mistake. No, I can work it. I did not think about that, but I can absolutely work that. Yeah, I need to run this through because I need to get... You see, that's what you have at last minute. I did not think this through, but I'm sure it will work. So get my die cutting machine. Get that part again. This one. And now I just need to make sure that I line up so that it cuts those two holes there. So this should be fine. So I just take the center here. Take a little piece of tape. Yeah, Esther, I see Esther. I think Esther noticed it. So I think she will show that on Tuesday. Let me see. I'm just, because this is kind of loose, so I'm going to put another piece of tape. Make sure it's lined up correct. Small piece of tape on this side as well. And then it needs to cut the two holes, but I'm pretty sure it will do that for sure. And then it will line up. I hope this works. I think it should. I think it should. Oh, it might not be in the screen. Oh yeah, you see it. It's in the corner. I was a little bit out of screen, I see. There you go. Oh, put this, don't drop it. So take this off again. You see now this should line up. Put this. I need to put everything back right away because in the, on the correct place, because otherwise, you see, and now this will line up. Yay. Happy this works. Okay, so now you're just going to put the tape and I'm going to use the thin one here. And I told it on Monday already, like the tape, some of it is out of stock, but it's almost there. So, it's almost all back in the warehouse. Should not take too long. So I'm going to use the thin tape. And make sure that you don't cover the holes, of course. And also make sure you don't put tape on your pop-up piece. Because you don't want to get stuck. Okay, and then take a little bit wider tape. Just for some pieces there. And then we should be fine. Hi, Regina's watching. Carol, the wonders of a creative mind. Who knows what we'll all come up with. You know, that is, and mentioning that, Carol, that is, if you are not member of our Elizabeth Craft Designs family group or the Planner Journaling group, go there because we have some very, very talented people there. And the ideas that they come up with are fantastic. And that's then I'm looking at it and I think, what am I going to do in my life today? Everybody is so talented here. So what am I going to do? Because some people on the group are way more talented than I am. So, okay, so we're going to hold this like this. Now I'm going to line up. So I'm going to, because you don't want to glue it on flat because then it's not folding well again. So you're kind of holding it like this. Then you line up those holes here. And now I'm going to fold this one over. And then I have a good pop-up piece, you see? So this one can now go in my book as well. Here we go. So I'm just going to put it in between somewhere. That's fine. So how cool is that? Working on it. Work in progress. So, and of course, I will. I can organize all my pages how I want it to be later as well. There you go. So now let's see where I have some space to put the little crab. He is so cute. Maybe I'm going to put him here. But then I want to have some. Let me see. I want to have some. Oh, I have this one. But that's actually for here. Here, let me show you that as well. That's also cool. I made the waves. Let me find a page for that. Because I was just, you know, that's what I do when I die cut, you know, start die cutting these. I just think, okay, what are the possibilities? So this one, I actually cut the waves only here. So kind of as a, you see, as a decorative piece on that shell. So I thought that was cool. So there's so many possibilities. And again, that's what I love to do. I love to just play. And sometimes, yeah, it always ends well. But sometimes it's a little bit stressful if you're really late. Because then you have that idea and you want to do that instead of the other thing. And again, this was kind of, I was talking about this with Anna, I think, just before the weekend, that I was going to work with this. And then I changed it to, for Monday, I changed it to the slim cards. And then I thought, okay, then I'm going to do this now. So you just line this up and see, and then you have just decorative piece. And this will be nice when you do a card as well. So when you do the card, so don't cut the holes. Like this will be a nice idea for a card as well. So again, different ideas. So let me find a piece for the, so this one I'm going to build later. So I'm going to just put a pop-up there. So that can be something like the card from Anita here, you see. So I can make that in there, or I can just put like something there and then put a picture here, because I know I have a lot of pictures from the kids on the beach, like different holidays. So I can fill it with that. Oh, that one should be here this way. I don't know where I probably turned it all. This one will be nice for the picture actually. Yeah, love that. So I'm going to put that one there. But again, I might change the whole, the way the pages are lined up now, because I'm going to cut more pages. So it might be totally different at the end, but it's all fine. So the paper I use today is the SeaWorld. So I use a 6x6. And for the people that came in late or later, not late, because you can come in anytime you want. So the SeaWorld. And again, all the paper, all the motor scrap. $2.50 for the 6x6, normally $5.95. And the 12x12, now €5, normally €10.95. And especially for the people in Europe, we have a lot of inventory there. So take your chance now. So now I need to decide if this is going to be a top or a... Because you see, I cut this one. So this is like this. Oh yeah, good that I see this, because this is like this. So this is going to be like this. So the picture needs to go like this. That's something you need to watch as well. You see, you really need to think as well. How cool was that? See, so two pictures there. And I love, and you can use larger circles as well. Let me put this one. I'm going to put this circle here because kind of nice, you know, colors nicely together. I'm going to put that there. You know, working on this, then I'm getting so excited. And then I say that more, but then I just want to go home and play. And I'm actually going to play this afternoon as well. But that's so cool. So check this page. Yeah, that will be fine. So you see, I can change all the layout. But you just need to watch, of course, what's on the other side. Because I just almost messed that one up. But here we go. And then I have, this one will be fun with the, look at that. Oh, love it. Yeah, that one is going there. And again, this one also came. This is a card that Josette created, I think, earlier. And then I use all the parts again. I like to reuse things. Let me see. Lots of rain. Oh yeah, last week lots of rain. Yeah, you know, it's here. It's that's what I say here. It's you know, hot, or then it's raining a little bit. You get some darker clouds. Joep van den Burgt herkenbaar. And I see tears of joy again with Diane. So I need to know later what happened. So I need to read it all back and I see. Okay, what was the fun about this time? Very warm in Saskatchewan, Canada. I have a sister in, so Josette is actually living in Banff, and my sister lives in Calgary. So most of you know we lived in Calgary for a few, or in Canada for a few years as well. Beautiful, beautiful country. Okay, line this up like this. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Just fun. And then I have two little shells. Oh, they go on the, oh, I can also put those, of course, here. Yeah, going to put those there. And then you can just keep decorating. So, yeah, fun. I will have hours of fun doing this. So make sure I don't cover Tom here. I need to watch closely because I know he was very happy there, but it almost looks like he's almost crying. So maybe somebody jumped too hard, or he thinks it's his turn. So waiting for Opie. So I don't know for sure. I need to zoom in on that one. Zoom in on that one. So do some shells here. Let's see, and then it also needs the reinforcements. Let me get some out. You see, I can see, just keep playing. This is fun. I like this. Just play. And so how I start with these books, I did the same with the hearts. I choose a paper collection. And then, of course, what I want to do with this one as well, because of the beach kind of theme, I think vellum will be really nice in this. So I'm absolutely going to cut a vellum page as well. And you know, just have fun with it. But then I start just cutting pages, and it already makes me happy. If I can just cut pages and make a book like this, that already, then I'm already a happy camper. So I, you know, that's what I always say. I don't need too much, because so the red, now I'm going to do the blue. Let me see. Oh, I cut another paper, that one. No, that's two. Let me find two more blue one. Oh, here we go. One, two. Must be more. Because this one, so this is from the reinforcement sets. So that's this one. And you cut actually, how many? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 little circles in one cut. So that's the reinforcement sets. I think most of you have that right now because it's been so popular. And of course, with all the mini books, it's even more fun because then you can just cut and just make a box full of reinforcements. That already makes me happy. Case, hi Case. So that's my niece watching probably. It's probably not Case itself, it's Brenda. My niece is watching from the Netherlands. Hi Brenda, how are you doing? Nice to see you here. I see you here and I did not see you in the Netherlands. You know, that's how it goes these days. But I, you know, the plan is that they're coming to the US later this year, but I don't know how it's going to end, but the plan is that I will see them here. So look at that. That's a fun one. And I have some circles left. So just start with the book again. Let me see. I am just going to add this circle here. And I can all decorate it later. Yeah, Brenda, I hope I'm going to see you here. Let me see. Will be a great photo, yeah, great photo album, Crea Nancy. Yeah, that's exactly what I think as well. Just a small, like a small photo album. And it doesn't need to be, just pick fun paper. And it doesn't need to be, you know, very busy. You can just print fun pictures. So that's why I like it so much, because it doesn't need to be a very involved project. But this is definitely something I have hours of fun ahead of me. Because I just love this. Here, I can put this one in here. You see? And that's how I just start building the book. Leave some space. So I use all the circle dies. You see, so, and then I can either put an image here or I can just put a picture here as well. You see, and you're just going to build it like that. I have the, let me see what, if I have a page that I can put this one, because it's actually a fun one. Ta-da-da, let me see. Not in the, I cannot put it in here. You see, this would be a nice pop-up here as well. But I cannot do that because I have sticky on the back already. I have sticky on the back. I can put the lighthouse there. That's where the kids are. Now it needs to be more in the front. Because maybe I just put it here. But then I actually want to have some waves there as well. So be patient. I just want to cut. If I'm going to put it here, because I want to have some waves here as well. So I'm just going to do that process one more time that I have. Oh, this is paper. This actually has some... Well, it's going to be nice. I'm going to put cut the waves out of decorated paper. Yeah, because I have tape on the back of that. So now I need to think again. So this is going to be like this. So I need to put this one here. That's the thing. When you do this, you need to kind of think about what side some things are going. Because otherwise, you're ending up cutting out the wrong way. You can always use it somewhere. You can always use it somewhere. There you go. Get my big shot out. And now I have the other plate here. If you look, if you would look around me, you would see it's a miracle that I can still find everything here. Kind of the same as in my studio. So tell me honestly, whose studio is always cleaned up? Nobody's, is it? Is there anybody that also has always has a tidy up studio? Maybe Charlene. Charlene, is your studio always nice and cleaned up? Because she's very neat. But I don't think a lot of crafters have a very tidy studio all the time. Okay, so that's that one. Then I need a wave. I'm going to use a different one because it's fun, because the crab here you see is actually is in the sea, it's going in the sea. So I'm going to use this one. Let me see. So Joep, I don't need your comment about the cleanup studio. You probably made it already if you're still watching. So I want to know for my fellow crafters, if you have a clean, like always clean up your desk after your crafts. I try to, but it's not working. Hi, Annette. Annette Green is watching as well. Annette is on our design team, and Annette is also a very, very big fan and ambassador of the Graphic 45 brands, which are fantastic people as well. So put this one here. Run that through. And then I can use this as a wave. Put it back right away. Otherwise, like thin pieces like this, you will lose. So I try to always put it back right away. And then I need my page. So let's see if I'm correct here. Yeah, I'm correct there, just to make sure. And then I'm going to put the waves on here. And I'm not going to etch this because it's kind of has color already on there, but you see, lined it up nicely. And this one had tape on the back as well, this paper. You see, so now I have that one. And then I'm going to use this one on there. He is such a cute, cute crab here. There we go. So again, this was one that Josette colored earlier. How cool is he? And this one, some tape. Let me see. Is there somebody responding if they're... Let me see. Oh, I'm so behind. So behind in comments. We have... Who's been digging a tunnel for weeks? I don't know who that is, but... it's in my sluice. Who's in my sluice? Yeah, you are in my sluice, Brenda. Are you answering to that? I don't know, because I'm missing the comments. I will read back later. Here you go. So do that. And I think I have another circle there here. This one doesn't have tape on the back, so I'm going to use it as a solid. So again, for the people watching, comment, like, and share for a chance to win the $50 gift certificate. And the special for today and tomorrow is Yozette 20, and you get 20% discount on the full collection from Yozette. And all the motor scrap paper is on sale. Look at that. You know, I think because this is nice here, because that's plain, and then I'm going to put this kind of solid circle here, and then that will have a picture as well. So that one, here you go. And then I'm going to put the rings in to kind of give you the idea how it looks. And those rings, you know, with a photo camera, we send them to you. But those rings you can buy at a office store. Oh, this one is tight. There you go. You see, and now I have a fantastic, fun start of a precious book with holiday pictures in there. Of course, if you know, any holiday fits in there. Beach holiday, something with water, cruise. You see this one, so I can build on that one. Isn't that fun? Here I'm going to put a pop-up in. Here we have the lighthouse, pictures of the kids. And that's it for now. So that's it for today. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And stock up on your motor scrap paper, because when it's gone, it's gone, I'll tell you. So we have some left in the US, but a lot left in Europe. So take your chance now. $2.50 and $5. It's a steal for beautiful, beautiful paper for motor scrap. So thank you all for watching. And on Friday, it will be Suzanne here. And on Monday, I will be back. And then we make a schedule again for next week. So thank you all. And I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.